Hello! Welcome to this video tutorial about the synthesis of isoamyl acetate, a fruity fragrance. The reaction between amyl alcohol and acetic acid is an example of a general process where alcohols and acids render esters and water. The mechanism of the reaction involves initial protonation of the acid. The acid gets activated towards the nucleophilic attack of the alcohol. A new carbon-oxygen bond is thus formed. The proton from the initial protonation moves around from one oxygen to the next throughout different equilibriums. At a certain point, an incipient water molecule is formed. The water molecule is finally released, and the initial proton is liberated to protonate another acid molecule and start back the process all over again that yields the targeted ester. Let's review first the reagents and materials you are gonna need. The first step of the process consists of the setting or a reflux or the hard boiling of a mixture. Let's measure the first reagent, isoamyl alcohol. Since the alcohol is a liquid, one possibility is the use of a graduated cylinder. By means of the density, the volume is easily converted into weight, which corresponds to a number of moles. But in any case, I do advise you to weigh the liquid. You can do that in the balance. In that way, you are sure of the precise contents of your reaction flask. The setting of the reflux needs of continuous stirring to avoid overheating of the liquid. The next reagent to measure is glacial acetic acid. The formation of esters by the method of this practice is usually an equilibrium that must be shifted to the final products by the use of an excess of one of the reagents. In the This question has just been answered, hasn't it? Finally, the strong acid, the catalyst, sulfuric acid. We saw in the mechanism that the proton is recovered and used all over and over again. Therefore, just a few drops will do. Please, be extremely careful with sulfuric acid because it's tremendously corrosive. All reagents are already mixed. The hard boiling of the reflux implies the use of an efficient condenser to trap the vapors, condense them, and return the liquid to the reaction flask without any losses. The condenser is refrigerated by the continuous pass of tap water or the use of a closed circuit chiller. In our case, the reflux won't be long, and a very small stream of tap water will do. For longer refluxes, for instance overnight ones, the closed circuit chiller would avoid the waste of lots of water. Water must enter the condenser by the bottom part of it in order to get it completely filled and without bubbles. Just a slight dripping would be more than enough. Let's start the heating. Control the heating with a thermometer with its valve located into the sun. After several minutes of heating, you'll see the start of the boiling. But a reflux implies a hard boiling. That means that at the bottom of the condenser, there should be a lot of activity. Can you see it? If you can't, please raise the temperature as needed. That's now the true reflux. Please leave it heating for approximately 1 hour. Allow the reaction mixture to cool. Maybe you need to raise the flask from the sand to get a faster cooling. The reaction mixture must be treated now in order to get the desired ester. This is called the reaction workup. Don't forget that we used a large excess of acetic acid. We do need to get rid of it. Any ideas about how to accomplish that? Acetic acid is a relatively strong organic acid that can be extracted with sodium bicarbonate. Don't you recall doing anything similar in the extraction practice? Isoamyl acetate is a bit soluble in water, but brine helps avoiding losing any of it because the large amount of salts severely limits the room to get dissolved in the aqueous layer. A As it is usual when neutralizing an acid with bicarbonate, please be careful with the strong effervescence that can spill and ruin your reaction. In the extraction practice, neutralization of an acid phase led to a precipitate. However, do not expect any now, because isoamyl acetate is a neutral liquid. You have to have looked for the density of isoamyl acetate. It's lower than that of the concentrated dense aqueous layer and stays on top. You learned from the extraction practice to keep all these precautions. It's essential that the acetic acid is completely removed. Please repeat the extraction with bicarbonate twice more. This crystal clear liquid is almost ready for its distillation, but it has to be dried first with anhydrous magnesium sulfate. In the last step, you will purify isoamyl ester by simple distillation. Yeah. filter the desiccant salt off. Rinse the remainder in the flask with DCM, but not too much. Once more, the continuous stirring throughout distillation will prevent overheating. Make always water enter at the lowest part of the condenser. Make sure that the valve of the thermometer is at the right height, otherwise the temperature reading would be slightly lower than that expected. It's all set now. You can start heating. Remember that you have a few ml of DCM that will distill first at very low temperature. Please read and follow carefully the indications. Thank you. This is it. You have synthesized and purified your first organic product. Do you smell it? Bananas? One moment, please. Let me check your performance. Congratulations for your nice performance. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did recording it for you. Cheerio!